Hello all, in this video we will quickly go through a simple method to upload the nail photographs on the Google Slides. So we'll first see the method through a mobile phone and then we'll proceed with the laptop or desktop. So from the mobile phone you will have to download the Google Slides app from the Play Store. Click on Play Store here and download the Google Slide app. So search for Google Slides and then install the application. Meanwhile the application gets installed, I'll share with you a very important thing. So we are receiving this photograph of the nail, so we should not leave it like that. We should keep a track of the data, because as it is data we need to keep a track of it, because it will be needed for further analysis. In this sense we'll have to derive some conclusion out of the data that we are receiving. So it will also help us in understanding the basic working or physiology of how the cells work and how the nail grows, and is there any effect of some other factors such as any comorbidity and stuff. So yeah, the application got installed, so click on open. It is just a basic message here, so click on skip. I'll rotate the screen and the first you will see the nail regeneration observations. So as I had opened this earlier, I am seeing it for the year, but if you want to visualize it then or open the document, you'll have to click on the link which is there in the description of the group. Once you click on the link, it will open this document. Yeah, so this is how the document looks like. This is the first slide and this is just the viewing mode. You will not be able to edit the document from here. To start editing, you'll have to click on the slide for some time and then release your finger and there will be an option to edit. So click on edit. Yeah. On the left side you can see that there are a lot of slides that are seen, right? Yeah, and if you just go down there are almost 67 slides here. So if you are doing it for the first time, you'll have to create your own slide. So for creating your own slide you need to click here on the 67th slide. Just keep it clicked. And no, yeah, keep it clicked and click on copy here. Then once copied, then click on the cross here and then just again click on the 67th slide. There will be an option to paste. So click on paste. Here you can see that the slide got duplicated, right? Now you'll have to edit it. So first you need to remove this picture which is already there, the duplicated one. Click on the picture and click on delete. And then edit the required information. The required information is the details of the finger, which finger is it, and the initials. So here the initial is the first and the first names of the letters of the name, and followed by the gender and age, and the date of marking is important, the date on which the nail was marked with the particular water's ink or mehendi in some cases. And the next is the name of the coordinator. So if you are the coordinator yourself, you can edit the name here. And yeah, so if you have you are starting for the first time, then you need to enter it on the week 1. So to proceed, you'll have to upload the picture. To upload the picture, what you need to do is click on plus here and then it will give an option to insert. Click on image and click on from photos. If you have it in your gallery, then you'll have to click on from photos. I have it in my gallery. Yeah, so I'll click on this, the first photograph I have. So it will appear. As it is a large one, I need to resize it. So just drag around the corners and it will get resized. Yeah, just a minute. So you need to resize the photograph. Inside the box, you can also crop the photograph by just clicking on the square box here at the bottom. Click on crop and then you can then just crop the photograph as per your convenience. I have cropped it and I'll put it inside the box and then enter today's date because this photo was taken today. So I'll have to edit that. I'll edit the date. Today is 5th of June. 5th June 2021. And click on the tick mark here. And obviously you'll have to edit the other things as well. Once this is done, you can close the slide and make sure that you are making regular observations every week and it is uploaded on the these Google Slides here. So it will, you need not save it, it is automatically getting saved. Now we will see the process to do the same on a computer. So I'll click on, I'll exit the application, mobile application. Let's go on the computer. Now here also it is a similar database, it is the same, but just that it is on a bigger screen and much more options are visible on the screen. Now again you'll have to go to the last slide. If you are a new entrant, see the changes that we made on the mobile phone, they are very much visible here as well. So again, if I delete the slide and then I want to duplicate, so if I'm doing it for the first time, I click on the 67 slide and right click here, I get an option to duplicate slide. I click on that and then I'll delete everything by making sure that I am entering all the necessary information. I'm entering the necessary information. Date of marking is 5th June and coordinator is whoever might be the coordinator. So here in the week 1, I'll have to upload the photograph. So for uploading, I'll click on insert image here, upload from computer, and then select the location of the photograph. I have it on my desktop. I'll open it. I'll resize it a bit. Now see, you'll have to crop this because it is quite large in size. So to crop, there's a shortcut. You'll have to just double click on the picture. It will, the option to crop will come and you need to crop it accordingly, then click sideways and then again resize it so it is fitting fine here, and make sure that you are editing the date of the photo. So here the date of marking is given, it will be like same throughout, but the date of photograph will change with every time you are adding a new photo. So similar ones will be added in the next or the following boxes. Okay, I'll show you examples of the other slides in which the boxes are complete. See, we have this one where all the necessary information is entered and the coordinator has followed up every week by adding the photographs. And also the date of photograph is mentioned here, week 1, 30 January, and the following has been done. So similar is there here as well. And if you have time, you can also measure the growth that has taken place. So we have another video which shows the tutorial on how to use the image meter app to measure the nail growth that has taken place. So we actually measure the nail growth between the proximal end of the nail mark on the nail plate, this is our nail plate, and the nail skin, the end of the nail skin. So we measure this distance here. We measure this distance. Okay. So thank you for staying in this tutorial. If you have any doubts, you can ask in the comment section or get back to me. And keep exploring this and keep following it up. Happy learning. Thank you.